firemen. Nobody knows why firemen are firemen. Not even they could tell you why. But it is time somebody try. Firefighting is the most risky of jobs. Fire and ice are uncomfortable separately or together. Wives hate the hours, kids love the noise, fire and ice. Any day at the firehouse, the bell puts the dispatcher on the horn with a tenement tinderbox address, into bunker pants, rubber turnout coat, grab the mask and go. Minutes later, you're on site. As others run out, you go in. You'll need all you can carry, the 4-pound axe, a 6-foot hook, the Halligan pry bar. The ceiling has to come down, and it's one of those stubborn tin ones. In the scary dark, you're gouging out and tearing loose and pulling apart, gulping air and tasting black. Your windpipe is closing, and you've lost track of which way is out. Is it really worth it? They've cut your ladder company from 6 men to 5, so now everything you do is 16.67% more difficult and more dangerous. Your air is low. Inside your mask, you're throwing up. There's a searing ember down your neck, torn gloves exposed, a smashed hand, so you emerge from the Holocaust hugging with your elbows somebody's singed kitten. Back at the station house, you can almost breathe again. Next come the tedious hours as you gang up on grimy tools. The cleanup crew at the firehouse is you. When windows need washing and toilets need cleaning and floors need mopping and beds need making, you do it. Is it worth it? Your B crew pumper swapped his day shift so some family guy could be home for his kid's birthday, and then outbound toward a false alarm, your buddy gets blindsided by a hot rod driven by a drunk, fire and ice. The intercom barks again. This time it's a warehouse, a big, fat, multiple blaze, on-site engine men draped with icicles, dragging a 3/4 pre-connect froze hose, are waiting for your big line. Laddermen can't make the building without you. Search, rescue, ventilate. Eventually it's over and out. Your smoke smudged and sleepless and wrung out. But this one you won. But the raging blaze that wanted to consume adjacent buildings did not, because you were there. Back at the firehouse before cleanup, you and the guys sit a spell, tired but they laughing, feeling good about one another. Nobody outside your world can ever know this feeling. In any other uniform, you get streets named after you. In this one, you risk your life to save people until one day you run out of chances, and at one final fire, either you buy it or you don't. And yet there is no third way that you'd ever leave this job, and you're doubting even God knows why. When you hear a familiar voice saying, it is worth it, and you're hearing this voice, and there's nobody there but you, it's a quiet voice from nowhere saying, it is worth it. Fireman.
There was a little boy sitting on his daddy's knee. He said, Daddy, what should I be when I grow up and I'm big like you? His dad said, Son, go to school and get real smart. Learn all you can and listen to your heart, and then it'll come to you. Well, months went on and years went by. The young man looked into his father's eyes and said, Dad, I want to be a fireman. His dad said, Son, I know you're tough enough. You got what it takes and you've got the right stuff. But tell me why. Why do you want to be a fireman? Then the boy looked up and said, Dad, I know it's gonna be tough, but I might save a house or fix a kid's bike. Maybe I could even save somebody's life. Now that's what I'm about. If I could save a little kitty up a big old tree and bring her on down to a kid like me. Now that's what life's all about. Helping your neighbor when the smoke first starts, putting out the flames that burn in your heart. Now that's what I wanna be. On September the 11th, 2001, a young man went out on an emergency run, but he never came home. They saw him go into a tower, didn't see him come out, but people on the ground said he'd help them out. Then he went back in, all on his own. Then his dad recalled these words in his head. I might save a house or fix a kid's bike. Maybe I could even save somebody's life. Now that's what I'm about. If I could save a little kitty up a big old tree and bring her on down to a kid like me. Now that's what life's all about. Helping your neighbor when the smoke first starts, putting out the flames that burn in your heart. Now that's what I wanna be. I wanna be a fireman.
Hard hard-working man.